This is Chicho. As always, welcome to my channel. Now, what I want to do for this video, this is going to be the 500th public video that I have available online on YouTube. So I thought for this video, what we do a little update of what we've done so far, what we're doing, where I am, and what's going on with some of the projects, some of the playlists that we have open, right? And sort of talk about some of the questions that have been coming my way, some of the requests that have been coming my way. Okay, now, since I think the last update we did was in June or July 2016, we've grown, the channel's grown, I don't know, about 25%, 30% since then. So for those of you who are new to the site, to my channel, to my work, welcome to my channel. I hope you enjoy your stay. There's a fair bit of different types of content here. And I sort of cycled through, covering one subject and then moving on to the other. And sometimes I mix them up. So, it is sort of flows in a chaotic, erratic way. But slowly over time, we will be building a lot of content for each of the topics that we're covering. Okay. For those of you who've been around for a while, thanks for sticking around. It's been an interesting ride so far. I'm pretty sure this is going to continue for quite some time to go, right? There's a lot of subjects, a lot of promises I've made, and I try to fulfill those promises. So I will be here for a number of years to come to at least finish off all the math content, and then we'll see where we go from there. And that math content is going to be, a 5 to 10 year project, and that's what I said about 5, 10 years ago. So it's gonna, we're gonna be here for a while. And thanks for sticking around. It's fantastic creating this content. I do enjoy it a lot. Okay. As for what we're gonna do in this update, now I took some notes. I've been thinking about this for a few days, and trying to figure out what we should cover, what the updates should be. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit up mainly the main topics, because there's a lot of things that we have going on. But what I want to do is sort of give you a feel for where I am and the content that will be coming up. Okay. Now, first of all, I got to apologize to everyone who's following my work for the comic book readings. We started off set number 4, and we did 2 readings, and then I got distracted with, as you know, I've been packing, unpacking, organizing, moving things around. So I don't know if distracted is the right word, but I really got involved, delved into that, and started opening up boxes and hitting some stuff up that wanted me to search more. So that's where I was, and I'm sort of getting set up to a place, very close to setting up a permanent spot so we can do the comic book reading. So they are coming, and there's a 30 more we're supposed to do, then we will be doing them, right? So far we've only done Will Eisner's Life Force, and we did Donald and Math Magic Land, right? They were great readings, right? And there's a 30 more comics that we're going to read to take a look at. Okay, so thanks for sticking around. We're probably about 5 or 6 videos out, 4, 3, 5, something like that, okay? As far as the mathematics content goes, I'm still going to go at it. That is the main theme of this channel. If you've been following the comic books, if you've been following the politics, economics, all of that stuff is going to link back to the mathematics. So ASMR math, language of mathematics, math in real life, they are open and they will continue to be open. Projects until we get them done, right? And that's going to be, I don't know, 5, 10 years or so, okay? As far as, one thing I did want to mention as well, what's going on with YouTube, with Google, Alphabet Inc., larger company now, what they've decided to do is to eliminate annotations, right? So they're taking that power away from creators. And if you've been following my work, you'll know that, when I talk about something, if it links up to something else that I've done, if I want to link it up that way, direct it that way. I usually have a video popping up and that's annotated and you can click on it and it'll take you to that video and take you to that playlist. And I slowly started incorporating annotations into my work, into the editing process, because it gave me the ability to connect up a few different thoughts. And I started setting up my videos, organizing my videos, so having in mind what I was going to annotate to link up to other videos, right? Because there's a rhyme and reason to all of this, especially to the mathematics, right? The mathematics, I've done a lot of annotating and videos popping up and linking to other videos, because with mathematics, it's one really language, right? And you can't, you know, this stuff is not very basically separated. So that's what I've been doing with the annotations, but that power is being taken away from creators, which I'm, in my opinion, is very unfortunate, because one thing I do, you know, one thing that does happen with those, with the videos popping up and little notes popping up, is they're basically little reminders, little triggers, right? So if we're talking about something in the video, and there's a certain technique in mathematics that you need to know to be able to solve a certain problem, I usually have that video popping up. When that video pops up, if the person has seen it, if they know the content, then that triggers the memory where they remember exactly what it is that we're talking about, and then they can move on, right? So it's sort of layering the learning process. But by taking those annotations away, you won't be able to click on those videos to go to whatever the information was being linked to, okay? Now, Google's replacing annotations with something called end screens, where it's basically you can pop up videos and direct people to other places, but I've been sort of doing that with annotations anyway, right? So they're doing end screens and they're doing cards, and cards is the same thing. You can have things pop up where people can click on them and stuff like this. And this is sort of, I don't know, I would call this, I guess, beta phase for them, because they've limited the number of end screens you can do and the number of annotations you can do. So some of my videos, I have multiple things being annotated, videos popping up or pointers to other videos, right? With cards, they limited it, I believe, to 5. I played around with it a little bit. They've limited it to only having 5 available per video, and end screen, I think, is 4. Now, for shorter videos, that sort of works because you can't really link too many things in a short video, but in some of the videos that I've been doing with the mathematics and comic books and economics, politics, different things, right? You know, sometimes they're an hour long, and 5 annotations, pointers to other information is not enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue editing my work the way I've been doing, because at some point, a lot of this content, all of this content, especially for the mathematics specifically, will be available on another site, on another platform, where I do plan on making sure things are pointed in the right direction, right links, right? Because, the end game for this is creating enough content to teach all of high school mathematics and to teach certain types of mathematics for people who want to get certain things done, right? Maybe mathematics of farming, mathematics of art and design, mathematics of anything, right? That's the math in real life thing that's kicking in, right? So at some point, all of those videos are going to be available on another platform, on my own site, and I will try to make sure, I'm not a programmer, I'm not a coder, but I'm going to try to make sure that everything is pointing in the right direction. So I'm going to continue editing my videos the way I am, based on the end game that I have in mind, right? My vision. I will try to incorporate the end screens and the cards into the videos in a certain way where they would not interfere with what I plan on to do later. Most likely I'll use the Patreon, you know, funding link, so people can link towards that. And the reason Google is taking this option away, they've mentioned that Annotations are not available on mobile devices, so they can only use cards and end screens. Now, I'm not sure what the rhyme and reason for that is. Maybe it's some kind of coding problem that you couldn't make it available on mobile devices. But it is reducing the interaction with the videos a little bit, okay? So my apologies for that, not having annotations available as of beginning of May, basically May 3rd, they're going to do that, take that power away. The annotations that were there before, they've said those are going to stay. I'm not sure how long they will stay. I spent a lot of time annotating a lot of those videos. It was sort of me putting the icing on the cake. When I would annotate, sometimes it'd take, you know, a while to do, right? Half the day, an hour, a couple of hours to do. But that's sort of me making sure everything's flowing properly, everything's, you know, pointing in the right direction. So supposedly, those annotations are still going to be available. If they're not, my apologies. At some point when we do move stuff over to another platform or where I can get some help coming in, I will link up all the videos that are being popped up in each of the lessons, each of the discussions, each of the videos in the description of the video, so you can see, you know, you can find direct links to those videos, okay? I just wanted to give everyone a heads up for that. Apologies for being long-winded about this, but this was sort of a tool at my disposal that I was using to a certain degree to optimize my work, and that tool has been taken away and replaced with something which is much less powerful, right? It's easier to do, it takes less time, but much less powerful. So I'll try to find some way around that, and hopefully Google maybe at some point will bring back annotations. I don't think they will, but we'll see where it goes. Okay. I've had a lot of people continue to ask me about politics, what's going on. I put out a politics video. I decided to answer some people's questions, politics video just before the elections was over, for the 2016 elections between whoever and whoever, right? What did Julian Assange call him? Gonorrhea, something else. That was a choice. So I gave you guys my opinion of the US elections and some of the problems with our political system, stuff like this. And I mentioned that was going to be the last video I did for politics. And the discussion opened up and people wanted to know more. And I started putting videos out mentioning that I was going to approach politics through the realm of economics, because economics and politics are one thing. You cannot separate them, right? And I sort of mentioned that I'm in the mindset of Chris Hedges quoting Wallen saying that the system we're in right now, sort of an inverted totalitarian type of system where economics trumps politics, and all political decisions, all decisions within our society are based on short-term economic gains, which is absolutely insane, right? So I decided to approach politics through the realm of economics, through the realm of mathematics, because once the mathematics comes into play, then ideology or ideology disappears. Interpreters, people interpreting numbers may interpret it in their best interest, but numbers don't lie. Mathematics does not lie. So my approach to politics is going to be to present the data and leave, you know, obviously I do have my own biases, so I will be leaning in a certain type of way, I guess. Just, it is what it is. That is my nature, right? But for the most part, I'm going to try to eliminate most of my biases from the economics, from the mathematics specifically. And I mentioned this at the beginning when I started creating mathematics, most likely in the introductory video to starting this whole project, was that I'm going to try to eliminate my biases when I'm teaching mathematics. I'm going to try to do that with economics as well, but economics is a little bit harder because economics governs our governs a lot, right? But once people see the mathematics, once people see the economics of it all, then the politics will become clear. So I rather not get stuck in the realm of ideologies. I rather present information in by quantifying it, right? I'm just looking at my sort of chaotic notes here regarding the politics. Just on that note, there's a couple things I want to mention. Okay, I was going to put out a video on this after the elections, but I figured I'd mention that since we're talking about politics. I mentioned that I was going to wait until the first 100 days of the Trump presidency. And we're almost towards the end of the 100 days, but it was pretty clear right off the get-go, within a couple of weeks, of the direction we were going. Okay. One of those things that made it clear as to how things were going to unfold was that the discourse, the dialogue had changed. Okay. On both fronts, if you want to think about it, the right, left, this, that, doesn't make a difference. But from the two blades, two angles, right, from the two-party system that we're in, the dialogue changed almost instantly, overnight, as soon as Trump was elected. Okay. The first thing that changed was that mainstream media, the left media, or the Western media in general, was now comfortable with saying that the president was lying, that the administration was lying. So if you looked at, you know, especially the left, which is, I find, incredibly hypocritical, right? But especially the left started saying that, you know, Trump was lying, or someone, spokesman for the US government, was lying, right? Which they were. I mean, 100%, they were lying. But that same media never used the term, the word lying, for the Obama presidency or when Hillary Clinton was talking, because it was obvious that they were lying as well. So from the mainstream media, the dialogue has changed. They're openly in conflict with the administration, I guess. They're using words that they didn't use for a previous administration that was doing exactly the same thing that this administration is doing, right? So they're biased. And I personally have reduced the amount of media that I've been watching from both the right and the left if they're showing their biases, right? Or if they're being, because everybody has biases, there is no unbiased media, but if they're parroting the chorus, right? So keep that in mind. The media is now saying that an administration is lying, but that's the same media that refused to say that the previous administration was lying. So take whatever they're saying with a grain of salt, their anger, their frustration, their how appalled they are when they say this administration is lying, because they refused to do it for the previous one, and the previous administration has done some, and, you know. That's one dialogue that has changed. The other, from the other side, the dialogue that changed was overnight, was Trump, right? Now, I haven't watched most of pre-Trump taking office, during the elections, right? I didn't watch too much of Trump's speeches. To me, it was irrelevant, right? It was interesting, some of it, because he was attacking the administrations, he was attacking the status quo and stuff like this. But I went through and looked at the ending of his speeches, and I couldn't find one time where before being elected, before taking office, or before being elected, really, he didn't take office until he was inaugurated, right? I couldn't find one instance where Trump ended his speeches with "God bless America." Okay. I didn't go through all of them. I went through like three or four. I went through his acceptance speech. He didn't say "God bless America." I went through the speech he gave before that and after that and stuff like that. He didn't say "God bless America." I believe the first speech that he gave, and I believe it was during the inauguration, and definitely the next one after that, he ended his speeches with "God bless America." Now, you can think whatever you want of Trump, okay? But a God-fearing man, he is not. Okay? Not the God that you might think that exists, right? So what changed? Why? How is it possible that someone who was running to become president, right? Before he becomes president, he doesn't say "God bless America." I haven't looked at all of them. If he has, let me know. But then the first speech and the second speech and every speech almost, well, I'd stop watching, but two or three speeches, he ends it with "God bless America." Something has changed. The dialogue has changed. Okay. Yeah. The last thing I'll mention regarding politics is, if you're still watching mainstream media, stop. Okay. Really. That's the only thing I could recommend. When it comes to politics, stop watching all Western mainstream media. All Western mainstream media, maybe BBC, CNN, Fox, whatever it is, right? Like CBC, Canadian News. It's 99% of it is, as they say, it's programming, right? It's one chorus. The type of information, the type of news you want to get are independent sources that have no connection with other independent sources. So the reason that you should stop watching Western mainstream media, because all of that information, Canada, United States, Europe, doesn't make a difference, UK, Australia, it's all coming from the same, you know, five sources, basically a handful of sources are guiding all that information. So it's a chorus, right? And if you're constantly exposed to, you know, the chorus from multiple different sources, as you might think they are, but they all have the same seed, they're coming from the same location, then they're all gonna give you the same bias, right? So you're only exposed to one bias, one point of view. So what you want to do is listen to multiple news sources that are independent. They're not connected with other news sources. That way you're not getting a chorus, a wave of information coming at you with one bias where you're going to get swept away, overwhelmed, and that's the only thing you're going to think about. You want multiple perspectives, and that's the reason you want to stop watching mainstream Western news media, okay? Now, throughout my work, I've made a lot of promises in the videos and in comments. Some of those promises I've fulfilled, mentioning that, you know, I will do a video and I've done the video, or I will comment on it and I've commented on it. If you've come across a promise that I've made, that there is no video for, I haven't talked about it, even in, if it's in a comment or a video, if there's something open that I've said I would do that I haven't done, send me a reminder and I'll kick those videos up in priority, okay? That's a promise, right? Because if I promised it, it means it connected it up to certain other things that I wanted to do. So that'll get the ball rolling on some of the other projects that I'd like to talk about. Okay. on that note, for me, most of my life I've worked at a contractor, and the way I'm approaching my work online now, because crowdfunding algorithms, programs, websites have really kicked into high gear now, where it's become easier to support your work. That's it regarding the promises. For those of you supporting me through Patreon, okay, you guys get first consideration if there's anything that you guys want me to cover, okay? Because I consider this work to be sort of contract work, as far as I'm concerned, if you're funding me, if you're partially funding me, no matter what it is, right? If you're partially funding my lifestyle, this project, what allows me to create this work, then as far as I'm concerned, you are my clients. So if there's anything that you want done, anything that I've promised that I haven't gotten to, anything that you would like addressed, post those comments on the Patreon page, and I will definitely try to incorporate those within videos that I've already planned out, or create new videos to address those things. Okay, I promise. Okay, I just wanted to mention that because a lot of the work that I've done, a lot of the work that I'm really proud of doing has come through recommendations, okay, has come through requests. So I do, and I've mentioned this throughout a lot of comments, as far as I'm concerned, this is not a one-way form of communication that I'm communicating with you in one direction, right? This is a two-way conversation. So what you request, what you recommend, what you like to see has an effect on what I produce. And I think that's an amazing way to grow the content on this site. Now, in previous videos, I've mentioned that, you know, I will do recommendations, reviews and recommendations and stuff. And I've done some stuff for comic books, and I've done some stuff for movies and stuff like this. And people have been requesting that I do a little bit more of that. I do have some stuff planned that I, you know, do want to do. But there's two things I'll recommend right now, two reviews that I'd like to give, because I don't know when I'll get to them. Because my queue of videos to do has grown a lot. One is a TV show that I've been watching. Now, there's amazing content being created right now for us to consume, really. We're at the golden age. We're in a renaissance right now. YouTube being one of them, okay? People creating independently things that we're missing online and sharing them, right? This is also happening through some mainstream media, but through specific projects that certain people are doing, right? So there are some amazing TV programs out there. Okay. The only one I want to mention right now, because it just started, and if you're not watching it, you're missing out on something absolutely brilliant, and that's Samurai Jack, right? Now, in the fourth reading set for the comic books, I believe we're going to read Samurai Jack number one, the series that sort of is the... When Samurai Jack, the animation, stopped with season 4, the creator, I can't pronounce his name, he went on a sabbatical and worked on other projects, worked on Star Wars, got pulled off, been offered a lot of money to go on, put Samurai Jack on hiatus. During that time, last year, a couple of years ago, I guess, Samurai Jack comic book came out, sort of continuing from where the series had left off, right? And rumors started coming out that Samurai Jack number 5 was going to come out, the series animation. And it just started. We're 4 episodes deep right now. And a lot of us that were Samurai Jack fans, we're a little nervous. I was a little nervous. I wasn't sure what they were going to do with it. Okay. And wow. Really. Blew me away. And I've talked to some people online too. And some of the comments, I believe someone commented regarding Samurai Jack, we talked a little bit about it. And incredible, really. Now, if you haven't seen the first 4 seasons of Samurai Jack, for sure watch them. There are 52 episodes. And for me, when I first watched Samurai Jack, I watched episode one, and I didn't watch anything else. I did a marathon on multiple days. I watched all 52 episodes, and I did it again. That's how brilliant it was to me. And I was shocked that it didn't continue. I was online, forums. Where's the rest of it? Where's the rest of it? Season five that just started, this four issues, four episodes deep, continues on from where Samurai Jack left off, but 50 years in the future. And it's dark and it's brilliant. I don't want to give too many spoilers away. But for me, one of the, it really, the first two episodes were fantastic. It was really good. You were like, wow, getting excited. The third episode just kicked it up a notch, like huge, right? It reminded me of Samurai Jack season four. I forget which episode it is. The Four Seasons of Death, right? So episode three from season five was very reminiscent of Seasons of Death and an episode that was Seasons of Death, I think it was. I'll for sure pop up the number here, but it was very reminiscent of that. Okay, and if you've been watching some of the mathematics videos, the color scheme that he used on that sort of gave me the inspiration to do the math video that we did when we talked about the equal sign, where I tried to use just white, black, and red. I wish my red marker was a little bit more bright when I was circling stuff when we were doing the mathematics for that video, right? So watching amazing, brilliant pieces of work really inspires me, and I know other people that create amazing work get inspired by other people, right? So it sort of feeds itself. That's why the sharing community is absolutely brilliant. That's why eliminating censorship and getting rid of gatekeepers, which is what technology is doing right now, why we're seeing a renaissance in entertainment and music and art and everything, right? So episode three in season five of Samurai Jack was absolutely brilliant. And then I just watched episode four a few days ago, and wow. It's got Samurai Jack is still there, right? The humor is still there. But there's a darkness to it. There's a brilliance to it. It's an amazing series if you're into animation and you want surreal artwork, really. I'm not sure if I'm using the right word, but the art is absolutely brilliant. And the theme, the story being conveyed is magnificent, right? So that's one series that I'm watching because people have been asking me what some of the series that I've been watching, right? And there are other ones, but we'll talk about those later. As far as comic book goes, I've been trying to catch up with my pull list. I fell behind. Okay, and the reason I fell behind is because I bought the Terry Moore Omnibus, and once I started reading it, I couldn't put it down. Okay, and that's one reason we've been delayed with doing the readings for the comic book reading for set number four, because I got immersed in this. I really wanted to read it. And this, brilliant. I got into Terry Moore. I read a little bit of Rachel Rising in the 90s, and I didn't mind it. I liked it, but it wasn't my thing at the time, right? I got back into Terry Moore after picking up Mortal Girl. And Mortal Girl's amazing, fantastic read. It's the new series that Terry Moore started. I think it's six issues deep now. Highly recommend it. Highly recommend it. But it wasn't coming out fast enough. I wanted to read more Terry Moore, and that's the reason I picked up this omnibus. And it was fantastic. And after finishing it, I needed a break. So I haven't read too many comic books for about a month now because I needed that to sort of soak in. So those are two recommendations that I have. Like, people have been asking me, do some other reviews or recommendations. So that's two reviews and recommendations in this update. We will do more in the future. We will do more in the future. The next thing I want to mention is one of the things I've done is I've made promises that I'm going to show you guys some of the other things in my collection, some of the other things that I've been collecting, right? other than comic books. And we've made a video, you know, we've done a lot of comic books. That's my largest collection of things that I have by a long shot, right? Maybe because it's so easy to collect them, there's so many choices, right? But we've done videos where I've shown you our plant collection and crystal collection. And when I started hitting, when I was moving, when I started hitting the math books that I have in my collection, we sort of did a video where I was showing you my math book collection, right? And that was awesome. It was putting up my book collection, my math book collection, and building the bookshelf. And some of you guys noticed that I built a bookshelf to hold the math books and stuff like this, and some of the other books as well. That was fantastic. It felt amazing. So I kept on going through my boxes, and I put a couple of other collections that aside that, or I've come across a couple other ones that I wouldn't mind showing it to you guys if you're into it. Okay. One of them is, one of them for sure that I'm going to show you, that people have been asking me to show you guys, and you know, asking me when I'm going to get to them, is my gaming collection. I have video games. I started playing video games in late 70s, I guess. I continued, and you know, there would be chunks of break because other things like comic books, other things become more important. You know, you can't spend as much time playing video games because you can't just play video games throughout your life. That means you're missing out on a lot of other great things in life, right? So you don't want to do that. But I've mentioned that I want to, you know, I am going to show you guys my gaming collection, and I have a few games from different periods. But there's a box that I hit that had some games from the late 70s, early 80s, handheld games that I'm going to show you guys as a teaser for a video, at least one video game collecting video. I might do two, one handheld games, one console games, one computer games. I don't know how I'm going to break this up because I've played all of them at some point in my life. But let me show you the handheld games that I came across. And if you're a game collector, you're going to get a kick out of this. Okay. One of them is this, and I played this a lot. Check this out. Diamond Hunt. And I haven't put batteries in any of these to see if they still work. I don't want to yet. I'd rather find some company or someone that actually can clean them before I can put batteries in and see if they work. But check this out. This is one of the rare. This is the only three screen one I had. Okay. And I had some other ones that we got rid of, unfortunately. I haven't hit them yet. Maybe they're in, I still haven't gone through all the boxes. But this was basically, I can't remember if we started up top, came down, or started down, came up. Three screen video game, handheld one. Okay. Let me show you a couple other ones. This one. Oh my God. Awesome, awesome. Ready? I don't know what year this came out. Played this a lot on the bus. We play this going to school. Okay, amazing going to school. Check this out, Devil Screen. What a fantastic game this was. Okay, I don't have the. This one has the back cover. This one still has the back cover. This one's missing the back cover. Check this out. But I have boxes of toys where there's just random things in there. I'm hoping it's in one of those. But that's going to take me forever to go through. And we might actually show you. I have a couple of boxes, actually three boxes put aside, where it's just random action figures, toys, things that I have no idea what they are, weapons, all in box, just shaky. And I have no idea most of that stuff is. So I was thinking about putting a video together where showing you one or two or 10. I got more than three boxes like that, and just showing you guys what they are as an ASMR video. And if you know, you post a comment, that way I can figure out what they are. Very much like the crystal video, right? Check out this one. Macros 2. Nice. And the way this opens, check this out. Look at the color scheme on that, right? Fantastic. It's like you're the robot going through it. Check this out. And it goes in. This one's in really good shape. I don't think you played this too much. I don't remember playing it too much. Donkey Kong and the other one I did a lot. And I don't know what year this is. I think this was towards the end. And it's really good shape. Okay. And I got one more here. This one. Oh, did I bring the other one? There's one other big one I found. I'll have to show you that later. I played that one a lot too, but I didn't put it out here. I think it's still in one of the boxes. Check this one out. Western Bar. Played this a lot. Casio. Right. And this one still has the back. And the batteries for this are the big ones, right? And crack this open. Check this out. It's got the speaker up top coming out. And I played this a lot. And I had a cowboy here where you're shooting things. And sometimes I believe beer was coming and you had to shoot them. Fantastic. Okay. So at some point we're going to make a comic book. Not comic book. Video game collection video. At least one. At least one. And at some point, I'm going to show you some of the toys that we had, or we have. They're in boxes. It's random. They're not in good shape. They were played with. But one of the things I hit was all the little mini comics. This is Masters of the Universe mini comics that came with the action figures, right? The toys I didn't bring down right now to show you guys. This is like three of the same one. Oh, but this one has a red tag on it. So at some point, I'll show you some of these, the toys, right? Yeah, and there's boxes, there are randoms, right? One other thing that I used to collect that I've collected a lot, a few years, is, check this out, I'm thinking about showing you guys my match box collection. And I have, this is the big jar, okay, and there's one, here's the next one, this one's not full yet, right? I like matches. Here's another one. So I got five of these things. Okay, so I'm thinking at some point we'll do Matchbox collection. Here's another one. This one has a lid too. Check this out. What's that guy? Universal Studios. And there's another big one here. Let me bring this one up. Here's the other one. So if you're into it, at some point, I'll show you guys my match boxes. Okay. Another set of books. I do collect magazines. I have collections of certain types of magazines, and I might show you guys those as well. Actually, I will show you guys those as well. They're in a couple other boxes. They're sort of random, but they're connected. They're fun. I plan on keeping those because I went through all of those. Okay. One of the stuff that I have a small collection of, and I know I have another box at least where I do have more of them, are these things here. Science fiction and fantasy novels. Okay. And most of these I inherited. They found their way to me. But some of these are mine. So what I'm going to do in the next two videos coming up, the match boxes we'll do at another time. I'm not sure when we'll do that. The gaming one has to wait until I go through all the boxes where I get all the games together. Okay. Just the way we did with the board gaming one, right? I got I hit most of my board games, so I was able to do the board game collection, right? Show you guys that. With the video games, we're gonna have to wait until I find them, because there's some that I know that I have, but I haven't come across them yet, okay? But this one we can do. Science fiction, fantasy books, okay? So in the next video, I'm gonna show you, in the next two videos anyway, one of them is gonna be this. I'm gonna show you, give you a review of the ones that I've read. And I think they're amazing, most of them. There's one that I stopped reading halfway through. And then I want to show you the rest, because one thing I want to do is get a recommendation from you guys which one I should read, because I'm really in the mood to read some sci-fi fantasy, and I do want to read some novels. Springtime, summer's coming up. It's, you know, having a little paperback carrying with you to the beach or to the park and sit down and read is fantastic. You know, comic books are amazing as well, but I do like books as well. So I do want to do a science fiction fantasy read, and I'll leave that up to you. When we go through, I'll show you all of these books, and I'll tell you which ones I've read and what I recommend from what I've read, okay? And the other video we're going to do, from the next two anyway, okay? Now, I've mentioned previously that I like Conan comics, especially Savage Sword of Conan, okay? And I hit... Here's one stack. Okay. Here's one stack of Savage Sword of Conan. And I've read, and there's another stack there as well. Okay. I'm not going to pull it out right now. But Savage Sword of Conan. Okay. I've read, I don't know how many issues I have here. I don't know what this is. But I've read all of these comics. Every single one, at least once. Some, at least twice. I've read all of them. At least twice. Some of them three times, some of them four times, okay? Love all of them and would love to read all of them again at some point, okay? And I've had family members, I've loaned these out to family members, only family members, because I know where they live, you know, one or two or three or four at a time if they're reading through it fast. And I've had other family members that have gone through these some multiple times, okay? At least one of them has read all of them. Okay, he went through the whole thing, right? Because they're absolutely magnificent, Savage Sword of Conan, okay? Now, in the video that we're going to do for this, all I'm going to do is just show you which ones they are, because I want to remember which ones these are. One reason is, the way this collection made its way to me was through a friend in the early 1990s, okay? My friend was leaving the country and he was limited, or mid-1990s, he was limited on what he could take, and he had to get rid of stuff, and he knew how to comic book collection, and this was his comic book collection, Savage Sword of Conan. So what he did was, he gave them to me, but as far as I'm concerned, he gave them to me for safekeeping until I see him again. Okay, so these are my friend's collection, and they will remain my friend's collection. And I believe soonish, I'm going to try to get a hold of him. I haven't seen him since he left, basically. And I think we talked a few times after that, but that was it, right? So I'm going to try to track him down and probably send these back to him, because I know he has kids and stuff like this, and I'm pretty sure he would love his kids to be able to read these, okay? So before I get rid of him, I want to sort of document the ones I have, and I think a video format would be fantastic. So in one of the next two videos coming up, we're just going to take a look at the covers of these, and they're not in order. I might put them in order, but I don't know, they're not in order, so we're just going to take a look at the covers, that way I'll know which ones they are. And for me, it'll be okay to let go of these, because at some point I do plan on getting this whole collection, because there's a lot that I haven't read that I want to read, okay? So I haven't read through these for a number of years now, because the next time I read the Savage Sword of Conan, I want it to be starting from number one and continuing, because some of these are story arcs and there's a couple of missing pieces in some of them. So the next time I read the Savage Sword of Conan, hopefully it'll be a complete collection that I can start from the beginning and do a marathon on, the way we did or the way I did with Terry Moore's Rachel Rising. Okay. So that's about it. I think I covered everything that I wanted to mention. The notes that I made. And again, for those of you who are new to the site, thank you for joining. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for watching. For those of you who've been around for a while, thank you for sticking around. Ups and downs. But there is a theme, and I do try to share as much as I can and fulfill as many promises as I made. And if you do know that's something that I've promised to do and I haven't done yet, please remind me and I'll get to it. Okay. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next video. And if you do like this content, if you do like this work, I'll mention it again. Support me through Patreon. Support this project through Patreon. It allows me to free up more time to roll out some of the things that I need to roll out, that I want to roll out, to make things go a little smoothly, and hopefully to bring one or two people on to be able to do some work in the background that needs to be done for us to kick this project up to the next phase, in regards to the mathematics specifically, but to free up my time to create some of the other content, maybe ASMR, comic books, food, or whatever it is, and get some of the gear that I need to get, that I want to get, to play around with some of the stuff, especially some mics, some of the mics out there that people are using for ASMR, because people have mentioned I should be, you know, they love to hear me with the 3D mics and whatnot, and with different types of gear, and I would love to create those, but I do need to, you know, make sure I stay within my budget, my life budget, that way I'm in the right mindset to be able to do this, right? So your support through Patreon allows me to do that, okay? And as far as I'm concerned, I'm contracting out to you guys. So if there's things you want done, recommendations, requests, suggestions, post them on Patreon, and I'll see what I can do to put them up into the queue, okay? Or move them up into the queue, or mix them in with other videos that I'm doing. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.